So in many ways, training has been part of the problem because a lot of the training is oriented towards this kind of threat neutralization approach where officers are subjected to all these videos of seemingly innocuous encounters that suddenly and unexpectedly turn deadly. And this has really contributed to some really terrible policing. But in addition, a lot of the training that's being discussed as a reform are not, I believe, going to make any significant difference. For example, there's a lot of talk about implicit bias training. This is based on some even questionable research that says, yes, people all have these implicit biases that that tend towards discrimination against people of color, and that and but even if that research is accurate, they make the leap of assuming that somehow if we bring officers in and we lecture them about their implicit bias, that this will make some significant difference in how they police. And I just don't think that's true. For instance, the main problems with policing don't require any bias on the part of officers. These are the political decisions to wage a war on drugs and a war on crime and a war on terror and a war on disorder and radically expand the role of policing. And also we hear things like, well, we need more diversity in policing, despite the fact that there's no evidence that this makes policing any better, that we need multiculturalism training. Again, no evidence that this training works. Some talk about things like de-escalation training, which is, you know, probably not a terrible idea, but again, unlikely to make a big difference because the problem is one of overarching, it's an overarching problem of over-policing, and the extreme violence is just the tip of this larger iceberg. So, you know, yes, some training is needed, but it needs to be the right training. But it's no substitute for radically rethinking all the things we've asked police to do in the last 40 years.